Good afternoon, everyone. I'm also actually project coordinator for the Europeana Awareness Project, which is a new project for Europeana that's going to start next year, January. And as the name already says, that's a project to really try to raise the awareness about Europeana throughout Europe. The Europeana version 1 project has ended last week, so this project is actually following up on that one. Europeana version 2, to start off, really fits within the strategic plan of Europeana 2011-2015. I think the tracks have already been showed a few times yesterday and today. So really to continue to aggregate, facilitate, distribute, and engage. And it's actually also builds on the existing business units within the Europeana office. So some quick facts about the Europeana version 2 project. It's a project funded under the Competitiveness and Innovation Program of the European Commission. Its duration is 29 months, and it started this week on the 1st of October, and will run until the end of February 2014. The funding we've received is 9 million, which is 100% funded, and the total amount of person months is 950. The overall aim of the project really is to facilitate the progress of Europeana, the content, its functionalities, the user needs, and also its network. We've got 10 partners in total to help us achieve our goals. We have, for instance, 3 partners that are involved in setting up and organizing a national conference running alongside the presidency in those countries. One of the first event that we have organized is taking place next week in Poland on the 12th of October in Warsaw. So there are 8 work packages within this project. There's one on user development, one on partner and content development, a work package on policy, strategy, and services, corporate communications, operations, technology, innovation, which I'm going to tell a little bit more about, and finally, management. So if you look at the overall structure of how the project is set up, this is how the work packages are interlinked with each other. We have basically 4 customer-facing work packages, which is work package 1 on user development. This is really communicating with our user network, trying to reach the end user. Work package 2 on partner and content development. This is really interacting with our partner network, our content providers, our aggregators, etc. Then we have a work package on corporate communications, really important to communicate externally also outside the network. And then finally, there is work package 7, which is the research and development work package, and this is involving the scientific community. Within work package 3 in the middle is linking the customer-facing work packages with the more back-end operational work packages, so work package 5 is on operations, on ingesting all the content that's coming from the partners. Work package 6 is on the technology. And then there's, of course, a work package on the management, the over-management of the project. So just to highlight the work package 7 on innovation, this work package can really be seen as a facilitator in this whole process to involve the community, you being here present today. We would like to continue to develop the research and development community. This work is also building on what's been set up during the Europeana version 1 project under work package 3. And we'd like to continue to do this with also existing communities. And work package 7 is really not just love, pull up. It's really, we want to be involved as a community of researchers and developers to actually do some work to help Europeana identify issues, to make us aware of any innovative ideas. So we will be able to set up task forces to include the community to help us as well. But not to forget, I think the benefits are not only for Europeana, but it can also benefit the cultural heritage and research communities. Thank you very much.